So what you're saying is, if you want an economical car, buy a BMW M3.
No, I'm not, actually. No, seriously, what I'm saying is, it isn't what you drive that matters, it's how you drive it. That is everything.
He's right, actually. Yeah, it's true.
So what are the ways you can change your driving, then?
One, ignore everything written in those handy cut-out-and-keep guides in the newspaper. You see, look,
there are a lot.
Remove your roof rack.
Who's got a roof rack?
If you're on your way to see the latest carry-on film, don't whatever you do keep your... Terry and June haven't had a roof rack. Nobody's got roof racks.
Nobody has them.
You could take other bits off your car, though, to make it more aerodynamic, like...
If you've got a Nissan Micra, you could take off the door mirrors, because nobody ever uses them with Micras.
Likewise, any van.
White vans.
Oh, I get this. Aerodynamics is good. So if you're transporting barn doors, say, carry them flat, not vertical in front of the car like that.
That's... The other one the newspapers are doing is remove excess weight. Don't carry a jack or a spare wheel. I mean, that's ridiculous. What if you get a puncture? But you could go on a diet.
Actually, do you really need both kidneys to drive? You can save a bit of weight there.
Technically, you don't need both of your testicles.
No, you don't.
Really? Did you drive here today? You did?
Yep. You don't need any.
You haven't, exactly. No testicles, and she's made it.
Well, that's a weight saving, right?
So I'm going to cut my ears off for the drive home, because I don't need them.
It's worth it, you save weight.
You could get rid of that spoiler at the back.
No, that'll ruin the handling. It's not worth doing that.
But if you did crash, it would be very economical.
That's true.
I'm going into this tree using hardly any fuel at all, because I've no spoiler on the back. It's a good idea.
BMW have built a concept car. It's called the Gina. Here it is. The important thing to know about this car is the body. That body is not metal. It's fabric. And you can see it creasing here, where the doors are up like arms on a shirt. You see it will crease, and, well, that's no good. You'll get sweat patches all round here, and it's...
That's a brilliant idea, that, because car panels don't need to be metal.
No.
Well, why wouldn't you make them out of fabric? You could have a linen one. No, not linen, because that crumples and makes you look fat. No, not linen, something else.
Well, I'd order it in smart casual.
Yes, because then you could change it in the evening, put a bow tie on it, could have an evening dress
or
car.
A funeral.
It's fantastic.
No,
what's
look,
wrong with it?
My point is, this is a rubbish idea. Look, I have another picture here. Look, it's split.
No, that's the zip. That's the zip so you can get at the engine.
It's got flight. It's got flight.
Yes.
All you've got to be doing, just be careful you don't zip your bell housing up in it when you're doing that.
Or your big end.
Yeah.
No, it's a rubbish idea. That is just a bag with a car in it.
Well, if Jag did one, they could call it the E-Type bag.
Yes, all right.
If Renault did one, they could call it the Espace People Carrier Bag.
Stop saying stupid things.
It's a stupid, stupid idea.
Great.
And it gets worse, because they say it's got... Underneath it, the structure sort of deforms and moves, and there's a spoiler that rises up under the material, and the grille moves, and that's just going to look like a car trapped in a bag, struggling to get out. It'll scare children. It's a stupid idea.
You could put a sticker on the back saying, my other car's a tea towel.
That's a stupid idea,
honestly,
too.
I wish they'd get on and make that. Now, Maserati GT, OK? You see them around these days. Got a picture of one here. And you know what this reminds me of?
No.
Cherie Blair.
Oh, God, it does! You've ruined it forever!
Look at it!
It does! It, no.
Don't what? Take it to Balmoral, it'll get pregnant. It'll forget it's contraceptive. And it'll sell all the stories of what you got up to in it. And it'll have a Scouse starter motor. Mind you, it'll probably come with two flats in Bristol, so that's all right.
Right, a new car. This is the Toyota IQ.
And now, I've got a thing about this. That's called the IQ.
Yes.
Why is it that all small cars these days are given names that imply they are clever or the people who buy them are clever? Like a smart. Because it should be the other way round. Because people who buy... I mean, it's like the Rolls-Royce Dunderhead Coupe.
They're buying big cars.
Yeah, stupid.
Yeah, so they'd have a Mercedes S-Clot.
Yeah.
A new Lamborghini Azaplank.
That should be called the Toyota Life Hasn't Worked Out Quite As Well As I'd Hoped. That's what it should be called.
That's dark.
No, but the thing I like about this is that all those small cars with the intelligent names tend to be really cutesy and hoochie-coochie-coo, which always annoys me. But I think that is actually quite a funky shape.
No, it's a good-looking little car.
But how much is it?
Well, that's the point. £10,000.
Yeah.
Quite
a lot. That's 3,000 quid too much.
Yeah.
So it actually should be called the Toyota I Really Am A Clot, I've Spent £3,000 Too Much On My Car, is what it actually should be.
Rejoice! The Vauxhall Vectra is dead. Yeah, it's gone. And here's its replacement. It's the Insignia. And first things first, you've got to say it's a good-looking thing, actually.
It is, actually.
It is, and it's not alone, because if you notice how many mainstream cars are coming along these days that look brilliant?
Yes. What was I looking at this morning? Citroën C5. That's a fabulous
that is
looking
brilliant.
And that Renault Laguna Coupe.
And the saloon.
And there's that Passat CC.
And the Mondeo. That's a good looking car. In fact, we're rapidly approaching the point where the only ugly car on the road is the Ferrari 430.
Well, that...
I think you're right.
Well, it is. It's nowhere near as good looking as that.
And now it is time for the news.
Yes, it is. And the big news this week is that it's time once again for the Top Gear survey. You see, we test the cars for a week. And in that time, we can work out how fast they are, how big the boot is, how comfortable they are. But we can't work out what they're like to live with every day. And that is where you come in.
What are you doing?
What?
What are you doing?
Well, this is what you do in the news these days. If you've not been watching news bulletins, they'll walk about with a bit of paper. And then they talk to a camera like this and then for no obvious reason switch to another one. Like that. And then another. Like that. Anyway, the point is that if your car is on an 03, an 05, an 04, or a 54 plate, we want to hear from you, OK? So please write to us at bbc.co.uk/... Top Gear.
Are you going to stop that now?
What? It's really, really...
It's very irritating.
No, I'm going to do the next bit, like Channel 5. You see, Kirsty Young, she's always halfway up a staircase when she does hers.
Yes.
Like here.
It's like news pole dancing.
It is.
No, that's worse. That is worse. Sit
is
down.
It?
Just try sitting down.
I'll give it a whirl.
But it might catch on.
Let's see.
What do you think? It's crazy.
We could do the news like this. What do we think?
I quite like it.
Old-fashioned, well,
it's
like
nice,
head, Kendall.
Yeah.
Here we go.
OK, here we are with the sitting down news, which comes from Subaru, who are arranging a series of track days for £250. You can go to the Pro Drive test track and you can thrash around in an Impreza or one of those bigger ones whose name
is... Legacy,
that's the one. There's only a few conditions. You have to be 18 years or over. You have to have had a full driving licence over a year. Oh, and you have to be between 5'2" and 6'7", so that's you two out. Excellent.
That's tightest, that, frankly.
Tightest.
I can't think of a better recommendation, actually.
Than what?
Us not being able to do it.
Exactly. I'll be going. I'll see you there.
Yeah. Hey, now, listen, I have found what I consider to be pretty close to the perfect car. You know, last year I went to the south of France, drove the Audi RS4. Mm-hmm. Fantastic thing, OK? Well, they've now brought out this version of it, OK? An RS4 Cabriolet. Now, that's about as good as it's going to get.
I think that radiator grill's pretty gopping, though.
Yeah, listen, but Uma Thurman's got big hands. You're not going to say, get out of my house, are you?
Yes.
She's got big hands.
I don't like girls with big hands.
Why don't you like girls with big hands?
Well, it just looks wrong, doesn't it? You get
what
a woman
and
she says, hi, James, I'm Irma, you know, with a great big hand. That's just wrong. It's all big.
Get back. Listen, this has got 414 brake horsepower, four-wheel drive, goes like the clappers, sounds absolutely wonderful. Brilliant car, that.
You
brilliant.
Said, did you not, that the only person who ever looked good in the back of a four-seat convertible was Adolf Hitler?
Yes.
You did say that. You did.
I did say that, but it doesn't matter because the front seats in an RS4 are so kind of big and buckety, you can't get anyone in the back anyway.
Oh, brilliant. So you're saying the best thing about your four-seater cabriolet is you can only fit two people in it?
Yes.
God, you do talk some rubbish sometimes, mate. You really do.
£60,000 as well. Good value. Hey, now, listen. Anyone see the Monte Carlo Grand Prix at the weekend? See it?
Yeah.
Really?
Actually, no.
No, I didn't think you would have done that.
I didn't watch it as well.
No, they never watched Formula One, OK? Now, here's the thing. Michael Schumacher is on his hot lap, OK, qualifying lap, yeah? And then he kind of stops and blocks the road and everyone says, oh, that was cheating because he was going to be on pole position. Now, even if it was cheating, and I'm not sure that it was, how brilliant is that? You're driving 120 miles through Monte Carlo, like this, and then you think, I know what I'll do. If I just stop here, I'll block the traffic, so I'll pretend to have an accident and it won't really be one, and there I am on pole! Honestly, he's a genius, that man.
It's not exactly sporting, is it?
That's the trouble with Formula One. Everyone's obsessed about sporting behaviour. You see in the Nürburgring, do you see after qualifying there? There's what's his name, the other Renault driver, Fisichella. Fisichella charging down the pit lane to go and plant one on Villeneuve. And they go, oh, that's not very sporty. It is. He's a young Mediterranean racing driver and he wants to plant a big. On a stupid, short-sighted, baggy-trousered Canadian. And he should have got points for it. He should have got extra points for that.
So you're saying drivers should just get, like, random points?
Yes.
And who's going to give them these points?
Me.
Oh, there's a surprise. And let me guess, you're going to sit in like a big box high up overlooking the circuit, maybe with a crown made of leaves and a toga. And then at the end, you can decide whether they win or they lose. Like, really bad.
I like the leaves.
I hadn't thought
of the leaves.
I need that.
I would have given Schumacher 100 for being Dick Dastardly. There we are.
Right, can we move on? Only at your age, I'm worried
about
the
stress. I've got another idea. You know people in Sheffield nightclubs that are always egging their mates on to have a fight?
Well, yes.
Every one of the pit garages should have one of those. Hey, you see that Alonso? He was looking at your pit board.
Starting fights.
He spilt your practice lot. What are you going to do? You can't do nothing. He'd be brilliant. So listen, Bernie, if you're watching, you've got my number. Give me a call and some leaves. I'm your man.
On now to one of the coolest cars of the year.
What?
It is a Ford People Carrier. There it is, look. Look at that.
Now, you know last week, Richard, you banged your head while you were driving my Mercedes cottage. Has this...
No, seriously, bear with me. For one thing, it's absolutely... I mean, it's a seven-seater MPV, but look, it's really cool-looking. That is a great car.
He's absolutely right. I've driven it and I'd have it, and I'm a bachelor.
Yeah, it drives really well, and...
What I mean is, I like it as a car. I don't have to think, yes, the seats swivel, I can get a lot of brightly coloured mother care rubbish.
No, you can just have your little brush for cleaning your air vents in there, James.
James May on parenting, brightly coloured mother care.
Me and my brush.
Anyway, thing is, you can get that 2.5-litre five-cylinder engine from the Fast Focus ST, so it sounds brilliant, it's fast, it handles well. It's a cool car.
It's good.
What you're saying, then, is if your condom bursts, it's not a problem anymore. There's your answer. Now, ordinarily... Okay, ordinarily, I would not plug any show that these two are appearing in, okay? But James has recently signed up to host a programme on Sky 32, okay? Called When Sharks Attack, okay?
Yeah.
Now, this is worth watching because I've managed to procure a still from the production of James, and here it is. This is a show you cannot miss.
Is that legal in this country?
It's the Barbie doll thing. Here you go, the Ken and Barbie crotch. There's nothing happening.
No, that...
I don't know why you're laughing.
Oh, hang on, I haven't done anything silly lately.
There was a picture in the paper last week, which I've got on your Grail programme. The publicity shot, here it is. How small was that horse? Have you got a My Little Pony? I looked at it and I thought, that's what horses look like when I get on them. So God knows what that was. Anyway, listen, that is the end of the news.